means PQ is equal to QR. Okay, now to find the value of A, P is equidistant from two points, Q and R, means PQ is same as QR. PQ is same as PR, sorry, not QR. P is equidistant, no? So PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR, not QR. This much distance is same as this much distance, because P is equidistant. P is at equidistance from R, P is at equidistance from Q. So PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. So use distance formula and find PQ. So what will be PQ? PQ will be square root of P and Q. Apply distance formula. X2 minus X1 square, that is A minus 2 whole square, plus 7 Y2 minus Y1, 7 minus minus 1, 7 minus minus 1 whole square is equal to square root of, PR. Yes, tell me what will be PR? PQ, apply distance formula. Now PR, apply distance formula. So X2 minus X1 minus 3, minus 3 minus 2 whole square, plus A minus minus 1 whole square. Okay? So you will get square root of A minus 2 whole square. A minus 2 whole square plus 7 minus minus 1 is 7 plus 1, that is 8, 8 square is equal to square root of minus 3 minus 2 minus 5 whole square plus A minus minus 1 is A plus 1 whole square. Okay, so you will get square root of A minus 2 whole square, A minus 2 whole square plus 8 square is 64, is equal to square root of minus 5 square is 25 plus A plus 1 whole square. Now both side we have square root, so remove this square root. Yes, tell me how you will remove the square root. Yes, how you will remove the square root? Squaring both side, squaring both side, squaring both side, you will remove the square root. So square root will vanish. A minus 2 whole square plus 64 is equal to 25 plus A plus 1 whole square. Simplify this, A minus B whole square, A square minus 4A plus 4 plus 64 is equal to 25 plus A square plus 2A plus 1, A square plus 2A plus 1. So P, yes, again I am explaining, see here. P is equidistant from two points. P is equidistant from Q, P is equidistant from R. That means PQ is equal to PR. P is equidistant from Q and R means PQ is equal to PR. Now how will find PQ, length PQ? Apply distance formula. PQ, X2 minus X1 square, square root, X2 minus X1 square plus Y2 minus Y1 square is equal to PR. Apply distance formula P and R. So that will be minus 3 minus 2 whole square plus A minus minus 1 whole square, square root. Simplify this and then you remove the square root by squaring both the sides. Yes. Now you can cancel the same term on both the sides. Whichever terms are common, that you can cancel from left side, right side. A square, A square get cancelled. Anything else get cancelled? No. Okay. So you will get minus 4a plus 64 plus 4, 68. Minus 4a plus 68. Yes, what you will get? Minus 4a. Minus 4a plus 68 is equal to 26 plus 2a. Now, You take 4a on that side, 26 on this side. So 68 minus 26 is equal to 2a plus 4a. 68 minus 26, 8 minus 6 is 2. 6 minus 2 is 4. 42 is equal to 6a. So 42 divided by 6 is a. So you will get the value of a as 7. You will get the value of a as 7. So a is equal to 7. And this is the value of a, 7. So equidistant means equal distance. So P is equidistant from Q and R means PQ is equal to PR. Then 8.1. What point on x-axis is equidistant from these two points? What point on x-axis? Yes? Tell me. What point on x-axis? So this you have to remember. Any point on x-axis. Yes, complete the sentence. What do you like? Yes? Any point on x-axis. You have to take a point on x-axis. Yes. Any point on y-axis has y coordinate 0. Has y coordinate 0. So this you remember. Has y coordinate 0. Any point on x-axis. Yes, x comma 0. So the point will be x comma 0. The point will be x comma 0 because this is the point on x axis. So its y coordinate must be 0. Y coordinate must be 0. So you will write let a x comma 0. Let a x comma 0. Or you can take p, no problem. Let p x comma 0 be any point on x axis. Be any point on x-axis. Okay, now this point P x comma 0, this point P x comma 0, this is equidistant from two points. This is equidistant from two points. What are the two points? 7 comma 6 and minus 3 comma 4. 7 comma 6 and minus 3 comma 4. Minus 3 comma 4. So this I can take Q, this I can take R. Okay? So P is equidistant from Q, P is equidistant from R. So what you will get? Tell me. PQ is equal to PR. Yes? So P is equidistant from Q and R. So you will get PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. Use distance formula. Find PQ. Use distance formula. Find PR. Square both the side and simplify. You will get the answer. So further part I am giving homework. Yes? All of you can solve this or not? Yes, all of you can solve this. No, PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR because P is equidistant. In this, we are given any point on x-axis. So its y coordinate must be 0. So any point on x-axis will be of the form x comma 0. Okay? You can take a comma 0, no problem. But its y coordinate must be 0. Now ninth one, find a point on y-axis. Ninth one. Now we have to take a point on y-axis. So we write any point on y-axis. Yes, complete the sentence. Has x coordinate 0. X coordinate means first coordinate. Any point on y-axis has x coordinate 0. So you can take a point, let P 0 comma y, because x coordinate is 0, because it is a point on y-axis. Let P 0 comma y be any point on y-axis. be any point on y-axis. Now it is given that P is equidistant from 5, 2. So P, 0, y, small y. This is equidistant from Q. What is Q? 5, 2. And equidistant from R. R is -4, 3. So P is equidistant. P is equidistant from Q. So PQ is equal to PR. PQ is equal to PR. Solve this. Find the value of Y, and that will be the coordinate of that point. Okay. So you have to substitute the value of Y. You will get the coordinate P 0, whatever is the value of Y. So homework. Then 10th is also homework. 10th is also homework. Morning I have taught you ordinate and abscissa. Abscissa means x coordinate. Ordinate means y coordinate. Abscissa means x coordinate. Ordinate means y coordinate. So morning I have taught you abscissa and ordinate. So 10th one you can do it. Homework. Now 11th one. Show that the points P 0, 5, Q 5, 10 and R 6, 3 are the vertices. So you are given a triangle P Q R. Okay, P is a vertex, Q is a vertex, and R is a vertex. And what are vertices? Yes, vertices are PQ. See here, there is a difference. Vertex means point P, point Q, point R. And vertices means sides. Vertices means sides. What are the sides of this triangle? PQ, QR, and PR. Now the coordinate of P is given 0, 5. Coordinate of Q is given 5, 10, and coordinate of R is 6, 3. Show that these are the vertices of isosceles triangle. Yes? So when the triangle will be isosceles triangle, tell me, whenever any two sides are equal. Yes. So we find all the sides. We find PQ, we find QR, we find PR, and show that any two sides are equal. Any two sides are equal for isosceles triangle. For isosceles triangle, we show that any two sides are equal. So let us use distance formula and find PQ. Find PQ, QR, and PR. And then at the end we check whether any two sides are equal. If any two sides are equal, then these are the vertices. Vertices means sides of isosceles triangle. Okay, so this part is not required, directly be like this. So that these are the vertices of isosceles triangle. Okay. So now find PQ, what will be PQ? PQ will be square root of, consider P and Q, apply distance formula. So x2 minus x1, 5 minus 0 square plus 10 minus 5 square. So PQ will be square root of 5 minus 0 square is 25 plus 10 minus 5. 5 square is 25. 25 plus 25 is root 50. Root 50 you can write 5 root 2. This 50 I can write 25 into 2. So PQ is 5 root 2 unit. We write unit. 5 root 2 unit. Okay, because unit is not given, so we write unit. Now find QR. Find QR. So consider QNR as an applied distance formula. QNR, applied distance formula. So x2 minus x1, 6 minus 5 whole square plus 3 minus 10 whole square. So square root of 6 minus 5 is 1 square plus 3 minus 10 is minus 7 square. So square root of 1 square, 1 minus 7 square, 49. So that will be root 50. Root 50 is same as 2 root 5. So QR is equal to 5 root 2. QR is equal to 5 root 2 unit. QR is equal to 5 root 2 unit. Let us find PR. Let us find PR. Let us my dear. We got two sides equal. Let us check whether third side is also equal. They can give you equilateral triangle also. Then they can give the question. These are the vertices of which triangle. Then in that case you have to work out. So let us find PR. PR will be square root of x2 minus x1, 6 minus 0 square plus 3 minus 5 whole square. So PR is 6 minus 0 square is 6 square plus 3 minus 5 minus 2 whole square. So PR is 6 square is 36, 36 plus minus 2 square is 4, 40. So PR is root 40. PR is root 40. Okay, so you can clearly make out. Screen is clear. Okay, sometimes it happens. So PQ is root 50. What is PQ? Root 50. So which two sides are equal, my dear? PQ and QR are equal, no? Yes. So we write PQ. PQ is equal to QR is equal to root 50. Root 50 unit. So these two sides are equal. PQ is equal to QR. These two sides are equal. And therefore these form the vertices of an isosceles triangle. Therefore PQR are the vertices of isosceles triangle. Are the vertices of isosceles triangle. They PQR form the vertices of isosceles triangle because two sides are equal. Okay, two sides are equal, so they form the vertices of isosceles triangle. Two sides are equal, so they form the vertices of isosceles triangle. Is it clear? Yes. Okay, tell. Then next question, a rectangle. Okay. What is that? Well, prove that PQRS are the vertices of rectangle. Okay. 12th one. Prove that PQRS. Let us take P. What is the coordinate of P? 0 comma minus 4. And Q. PQRS. PQ. Q is 6 comma 2. R 3 comma 5. R 3 comma 5. And S. Not 3 comma 5. 6 comma 2, R is 3 comma 5, okay. 0 comma minus 4, 6 comma 2, 3 comma 5, yes. S minus 3 comma minus 1. S is minus 3 comma minus 1. These are the vertices of, yes, they form the vertices of, they are the vertices of rectangle. So for rectangle, what we show? Yes, what is the property of, only opposite sides are equal. There are few more properties. Yes, there are few more properties of rectangle. Yes, what are those properties of rectangle? Opposite sides are equal. Yes, opposite sides are equal. So to show that PQRS are the vertices of rectangle, we show that two things we show. First, opposite sides are equal. This thing should not be written in the exam. Opposite sides are equal. I am writing, you can skip this. Opposite sides are equal means you show that PQ is equal to RS or SR, whatever. Then PS is equal to QR. You show that opposite sides are equal. You show that this side is same as this side. This side is same as this side. Then apart from this, opposite sides are equal, you have to show that diagonals are also equal. Diagonals are also equal. So what are the diagonals? Tell me. What are the diagonals? Yes? Diagonals are also equal. So diagonal means PR. PR and QS. Correct? Diagonals are also equal. Means this side, this diagonal is same as this diagonal. So diagonals are also equal. Means you have to show that PR is equal to QS. Okay, so now using distance formula, you will find PQ, you will find SR. Check whether they are equal, okay. Then you will find PS, you will find QR. They are equal means opposite sides are equal. Then you will find diagonal PR, you will find diagonal QS using distance formula. PR, consider P and R, use applied distance formula. So further part I am giving homework, calculation. Okay. Yes? Is it clear? Yes or no? You can do it. Show that the opposite sides are equal and diagonals are also equal using distance formula. So you find PQ, you find SR, you find PS, you find QR. And show that the opposite sides are equal for rectangle and the diagonals are also equal. So for rectangle, the opposite sides are equal and the diagonals are also equal. The next one is 13. Prove that are the vertices of isosceles right angle triangle. Find the area of the triangle. Okay. 13. Chalo, let me do 13. ABC, let me write ABC, ABC, let me write ABC, okay, ABC, prove that ABC, we are not sure which angle is right angle triangle, okay, so A is 1, minus 3, B is minus 3, 0, and C is 4,1. C is 4,1. Okay. Now you find the sides. You find the sides AB, BC and AC. Yes, you find AB, BC and AC. And check whether it is isosceles triangle. Any two sides are equal. So let us find AB. Apply distance formula AB. X2 minus X1 minus 3 minus 1 whole square plus 0 minus minus 3 whole square. So AB will be minus 4 square plus 0 minus minus 3 is 3 square. So AB is minus 4 square is 16 plus 3 square is 9. 16 plus 9 25. So AB is root of 25. So AB is 5. AB is 5. Okay. In this case, it is isosceles right angle triangle. So first we check whether it is isosceles. Then we check whether it is right angle triangle or not. Okay. So first we check whether it is isosceles triangle. So you find all the three sides, AB, BC and AC. Okay. Yeah. Find BC. B and C. Apply distance formula. B and C. So X2 minus X1, 4 minus minus 3 square. 4 minus minus 3 square plus 1 minus 0 square. So BC will be 4 minus minus 3 is 4 plus 3. That is 7 square plus 1 square. So BC will be 7 square is 49. 49 plus 1. So BC is root 50. BC is root 50. Correct. So BC is 5 root 2. 5 root 2 unit. 5 root 2 unit. Let us check. We have to find all the three sides. AB, BC and AC. Let us find AC. AC will be square root of, now consider A and C. A and C, apply distance formula. 4 minus 1 square, 4 minus 1 whole square, plus 1 minus minus 3 whole square. 1 minus minus 3 whole square. So 4 minus 1 is 3 square, plus 1 minus minus 3 is 4 square. So 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16. So AC is root 25. What is root 25? Yes, what is root 25? Root 25 will be 5. So AC is 5 unit. AC is 5 unit. Okay. AC is 5 unit. AC is 5 unit. Now we have found all the three sides. Now which two sides are equal? Yes, AB is 5 unit. BC is, AC is 5 unit. So AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC is equal to 5 unit. Okay, so triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Let us draw the triangle. AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. Okay. So AB is equal to AC. So this is my A. AB is equal to AC. Let us draw the triangle now. AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. This is phi. This is phi. And BC is phi root 2. Okay, so two sides are equal. So this is isosceles triangle. So triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle. Now we want to show that it is right angle triangle. And right angle triangle we apply for, whenever we have right angle triangle, we check whether Pythagoras theorem is verified. So verify Pythagoras theorem. verify Pythagoras theorem for right angle. Verify Pythagoras theorem. Yes, verify Pythagoras theorem. So AB square plus AC square is BC square. Verify this. AB square plus BC square, AB square plus AC square is BC square. AB square plus AC square, verify. Yes. So AB square plus AC square is BC square. Yes, because this is 5 square plus 5 square is equal to 5 root 2 square. What is that? 5 square 25 plus 25 is equal to 5 root 2 square is 25 into 2. So 50 is equal to 50. So Pythagoras theorem is verified. Yes, Pythagoras theorem is verified. Pythagoras theorem is verified. Pythagoras theorem is verified. Okay. So triangle ABC is right angle triangle. And angle, which angle is 90 degree? Which is the largest side? The largest side is BC. So hypotenuse is the largest side, my dear. The largest side of right angle triangle is hypotenuse. And the angle opposite to hypotenuse is 90 degree. So my angle A is 90 degree. And angle A is 90 degree. So triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Triangle ABC is right angle triangle. Therefore, triangle ABC is isosceles right angle triangle. Triangle ABC is isosceles right angle triangle. Because triangle ABC is isosceles, triangle ABC is right angle. So triangle ABC is isosceles right angle triangle. And what is area of triangle? Yes. Can you tell me what is area of triangle? Yes. Yes, anybody. What is area of triangle? Half into base into height. So see here. This is 90 degree. That means this is my perpendicular. This is my height and this is my base. This is not my base. Okay. So this I can consider base. And this I can consider height, because between them base and height 90 degree angle is formed. So area of triangle ABC, A means area. Area of triangle ABC is half into base into height. So that will be half into base. What is that base? Half into base into height. What is asked? Find the area of the triangle. Yes. Find the area of the triangle. So half into base. Base is 5. Into height is 5. So that is 25 by 2. That is 12.5. So you will write square unit. Area will be in square unit. So area of triangle is 12.5 square unit. Area of triangle will be 12.5 square unit. Yes, clear? Area of triangle will be 12.5 square unit. Is it clear? So let me write final answer. Area of triangle ABC is 12.5 square unit. The length is measured in unit and the area is measured in square unit. Okay, so two things we have shown in this. First, we have found all the three sides AB, BC and AC. then AB and AC was equal. So AB is equal to AC, means any two sides are equal. So this is the isosceles triangle. Then to check whether this is right angle isosceles triangle, we check whether Pythagoras theorem is verified. AB square plus AC square is BC square. That means Pythagoras theorem is verified, means this is right angle triangle. And which angle will be 90 degree? The angle opposite to largest side of the right angle triangle, right? The largest side of the right angle triangle is hypotenuse. The angle opposite to hypotenuse will be 90 degrees. So angle is 90 degree. Angle is 90 degree. So this will be base, this will be height. Then area of triangle is half base into height, half phi into phi, that is 12.5. You will get the answer. Okay. So now we stop here. It is 12:30. Bye everybody. All of your marks are visible, no, on MICM. Okay. Bye bye. Bye 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 bye.